been to Seoul before?
No, this is my first time actually. I mean, it's beautiful. Just look at that. Oh, no, I like maybe we'll go dipping later. Yeah.
So I heard it's similar with other, you know, multi using apps like KakaoTalk or WeChat. What is the purpose of status?
Yeah, so in some ways it's very similar, I would say. You're absolutely right. So there's a wallet, there's a chat feature, but you can also access a lot of decentralized apps. And in terms of how we're different, we use S&T, which powers the entire network. So you can not just only, you know, pay for services and goods through Status Network, but also access, I guess, the stick market, that's something's coming out, and various other use cases that we've outlined in our paper.
So I think one of the biggest problems with KakaoTalk is security breach. It's quite vulnerable to voice phishing attackers. Can you say that status is safe from these attacks?
So security is one of our core principles, and we, you know, really take it seriously when it comes to our product development. So one of the things that we also do within status is that we never ask for any personal information. So we don't ask for your email, we don't ask for your telephone number. So
yeah,
it's just a
exactly.
Yeah, yeah. So it's something I guess people find it sometimes, you know, they raise their heads because it's different, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Even with major security issues, KakaoTalk is still widely used, not only in Korea, but also in other areas overseas. Mm-hmm. I can assume that drawing in a lot of users is very important for you guys. Do you have a specific plan to achieve this?
Yeah, no, it's a very fair question, absolutely. So I would say one of our, as I mentioned before, our key principles is that we want to emphasize user security. And while we're doing this, you know, develop in a way that, you know, to increase mass adoption, because at the end, that's what we're here for, right? So in terms of mass adoption, we're looking to build for a very specific core set of users first, most likely early adopters, because as a user researcher myself, it can be very hard to build for a very large group at the same time. So by starting small and then, you know, building out, we can sort of, I guess, finally get to...
Yeah, exactly. I start using status, mm-hmm. so maybe I'm an early adopter.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay.
Welcome to the team.
As you may be aware of, KakaoTalk is widely used in Korea, right?
Mm-hmm.
Well, the app not only allows users to exchange free messages, it provides a lot of features like allowing users to book a cab, read news online, or even shop. I've personally used the status app myself and found out that although it's in the testing stage, it has a lot of features as well. Yeah. What are your main contender in the field? Will it be KakaoTalk?
That's a really good question. We were lucky enough to try KakaoTalk on this trip. I've used it back home as well, actually. Uh-huh. And I'm familiar with KakaoPay. We were very excited to see that Kakao Friend Shop. Uh-huh. Even though it's closed, we'll go back.
Uh-huh.
When it comes to like who is our competitor, I don't think for us it would be KakaoTalk. Mm. And that is for the reason that we do see status to be inherently different.
Mm-hmm.
Following our principles, thinking about decentralization, being private, censorship proof. Mm-hmm. So it would be, in our view, at least a very, very different type of application. But I agree, maybe the functionality in people's life is going to be very similar.
Okay. Apart from other service areas, why did status aim for messaging system?
Yeah, that's an excellent question, because there's so many directions you see
exactly
in the blockchain field. So if you think of blockchain as being a system to exchange value, like me giving you my words, or me going out to buy a coffee, all of it is exchange of value. It doesn't always include money, but it's exchange of value. That all starts with communication. So we have a conversation first, and then I buy something from you. Yeah, communication is key, and messaging is a good tool for that.
You nailed it. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Messages in the KakaoTalk app can be recovered in some private companies who do data recovery things. Well, this method is used by the police during their investigation and to recover the erased messages. Well, since status has its foundations in the decentralized P2P platform, does this mean that even the creators don't have access to the user's message records?
Yeah, exactly. So Status doesn't have any access to any messages, any media that will be stored on the device. And that's really because it's baked into the platform itself. We've also been recently developing a feature called Perfect Forward Secrecy, which basically allows for a user to have total protection over the history of their chat messages.
So you would say that security is your top priority?
Absolutely, yeah. So there's a lot of work that's going on in the Ethereum space to try and bridge that gap. Status simply tries to contribute to those efforts that are going on. We're not particularly responsible, like we're not one party that's responsible for it. So we do have an effort called the Nimbus effort, which aims to reduce the size of like basically the overall digital content that is transferred between different mobile devices. Yeah, absolutely. So Status really stands for the state of us. It's always really been kind of our motto. And the idea is that we would like to build a private, secure, decentralized platform to allow our community members to do all sorts of communications and transactions. This basically means that we can use our token to incentivize people to use our network, and it means that the consumer or the person using our services really is never the product, so we're not selling your information. Generally, ENS means, or it stands for the Ethereum namespace. Right, and it's really just a simple way for reducing what's known as the contact codes, which people have to use to get in touch with each other and to make contact with each other now, currently. And it reduces that down into a single username, kind of like an email address that you can use. So it's simpler for people to remember and to use. So that's, okay. Yeah, it's basically.
It's for simplicity.
Yeah, basically.
All right.
Yeah.
Send you a text message. Hello. Did you get my message?
I did, yeah.
All right. That's my username, Justin, and I edit you. Perfect. It's just like a regular messaging app.
Yeah, correct. Yeah. So see?
Awesome.
Your name pops up. Okay.
Oh, it's just like Taco Talk.
Exactly. Yeah.
Or just a text message.
Yeah. And from there, I can add you as a contact.
Uh-huh.
All right. And then I can back out. And if I want to send you some cryptocurrency,
okay.
What I can do is go back into the chat.
Mm-hmm.
And there's this simple icon in the right-hand corner. You pop that open. And there's a command there. It says slash send. And if you have cryptocurrency in the wallet, you select the cryptocurrency that you like.
Okay.
And you can send a small amount to you.
Uh-huh.
So I'm going to send you 10 SNT. I'm going to sign the transaction.
Sign it. Sign in the password.
So I sign the password.
Uh-huh.
Put it in. And there you go. Transaction sent.
How would I know I got? Okay, it says here.
So you receive a notification.
I just received 10 SNT.
Yeah.
And it's that simple.
It's that simple.
So no time lag at all.
Well, it usually takes about 12 seconds.
12 seconds.
Yeah, for something this small, like that amount that small, or 10 to 12 or 10 to 15 confirmations on the blockchain.
Convenient.
Yeah. Super easy.
Wow.
Yeah.
And likewise, I send my money, I mean my crypto to you, right hand corner, send whatever value I intend to.
Exactly.
Perfect.
Yeah. There you go.
That is awesome.
You've got some cryptocurrency.
I know, it is really awesome actually.